Okay, this is 16 inch AR with just a regular carbine buffer, and I think the spring's from PSA, where I got the rest of the kit from. So this is just kind of a volume test for your basic buffer setup. Yeah, you can tell from that clip that there's just a lot of spring noise. It's super annoying. When you start shooting suppressed, you hear less from the muzzle. You hear a little bit more port pop, but then you have this spring just making all kinds of noise right next to your ear. So I've been doing a little bit of experimenting with different springs and buffer sizes to see if I can cut down some of that spring noise. A lot of people have had luck with the captured spring systems like the JP, and there's another company, I can't remember off the top of my head, that makes them. They supposedly work pretty well. I have a friend who has one in his SBR, and it definitely works, but you still get a little bit of buffer noise from it. So I've been trying to quiet that down a little bit. I'll show you guys some of the stuff that I've done to kind of help with that, and I will show you the end product as soon as I'm done, because I did these same upgrades on my 10.5, and I went from hearing all kinds of spring noise on that to almost nothing. This thing sounds like a bolt gun actuating the bolt. That's how quiet it is. But I'll share that with you guys as soon as I'm done with doing the same upgrades on this. That way you can hear the difference on the same gun. So this is what I'm using for this. It's a Expo Arms H2 buffer. I used an Oveski in my 10.5, but in my opinion, H2 is H2. There might be some difference in the coatings on them, but I don't think it's going to make a huge difference in sound when I'm done with this thing. The spring I use is a Springco yellow reduced power spring. They use moly-plated chrome silicon springs. I don't think it really matters if you go with a reduced power or any other heavier ones. I think it's the coating and the spring material itself that they use that makes the biggest difference. I do grease those before I put them in because it helps cut down on some of that resonance in the tube that you hear, especially if your tube isn't really worn in yet. It does seem to make a pretty big difference. The more you shoot it, the more it wears down some of those tooling and machining marks inside. And the other thing I've been running is I've been playing around with a 3D printed buffer spacer that goes in the back. When your spring is in the buffer tube, normally it's just butting up against the metal in the back. And it might be placebo, I don't know, but I've been printing these up and putting them at the back, and I think it helps cut down on some of that spring resonance like I was talking about earlier. There's just not so much metal on metal contact in the back, so it kind of helps cut down on some of that noise that you hear a little bit. And like I said, it made a huge difference on my 10.5, so I want to do all of the same upgrades to this 16 inch AR to see if I can get kind of to that same volume level. So I'll show you guys what it's like after I get everything installed and the spring lubed up. Alright, I figured if I was going to lube up the spring and do all of the install, I might as well show how I do that and what kind of difference it makes. I've got the Springco spring and the H2 buffer in here. You can still hear that there is some spring noise. And this buffer tube is fairly new. So like I said, that'll wear down a little bit with usage, but the greasing does also help. The stuff that I had on hand that I like to use is just this GM Super Lube. It's got PTFE in it as well. It's silicone based, I believe, but it covers a wide temperature range, so you don't have to worry about it breaking down or anything like that. And you don't need a ton of it, you just need enough to kind of help quiet down the noises that the spring is making against the tube itself. So I just kind of go along it, get some grease at the edge, and then just kind of spread it around. This is probably a little bit much. A lot of people would probably advise against that, but whatever, that's how I run it. It gets all nice and lubed up. As soon as you're done with that, just slide it back on in the buffer tube. Wipe off some of the excess at the entrance so that doesn't get dirt and debris, but you can already tell a difference after just greasing it up. I mean, there's hardly any spring noise left. So I'll get the upper back on it, get back into the office, and I'll show you guys how it sounds as soon as I'm done. All right, well, now that that's all done, I got the upper back up on it. Everything has just been switched over from the carbine buffer that I talked about before. The spring's lubed up. Everything is how I did it on my 10.5, and so now we'll see if there is as big of a difference as I perceive after all this is done, and see if it transfers on video. Anyway, here we go. I don't know if that's coming through on video, but that is significantly quieter to me, just from a spring buffer change and some added lube. I don't know if the 3D printed buffer at the end is doing anything, but I have yet to handle an AR that is quite as quiet as that in the buffer tube. Just for comparison's sake, let me show you guys my 10.5 and how it sounds. So here's the 10.5. It's got the suppressor on it. The build is very similar. They're both aero lowers, and they have either PSA or Brownells buffer tubes on them. I'm not 100% sure. Nothing super fancy or anything like that. This is clear, just so you can tell, but this thing also is just incredibly quiet. There's no noise to this buffer assembly at all, which makes it especially helpful shooting suppressed. You're not getting all of that spring noise transferring to your ear. So really all you get on this is port pop from the suppressor being on there and getting a little bit of blowback through the bore. Anyway, I just wanted to do a video about that. If there's anyone else out there like me that wants the whole system to be quiet, especially after getting everything suppressed, and yeah, I just figured I'd put that video up for information. The whole system is what you want to be quiet, and not just the muzzle reduction, especially for something on your shorter ARs like the 10.5. Anyway, thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to put them down in the comments below. I'll try to answer to the best of my abilities. I haven't really experimented with any other springs or anything like that yet. I know the flat wire springs do really well as well, cutting down on noise, because they're not your traditional spring shape and material, so I know they help a little bit. I'll have to play around with some of those in the future, but for now, this is what I've found works for me. I think it's definitely worth giving a try. A lot of the guns that I've shot, the ARs that I've shot suppressed, like the H2 buffer weight increase as well, so I think you're really helping out the system as a whole, especially if you have an adjustable cast block to make up for those differences in buffer weight. But yeah, thank you for watching. Feel free to leave any comments or questions in the comments down below. Subscribe if you like the content, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks.